afternoon, everyone. Welcome to this, our second installment of the Basically Beethoven Festival. My name is Cindy Carm, and I'm president of the Board of Directors of Fine Arts Chamber Players. So delighted to see all of you here today. And I absolutely need to thank a few folks for making this concert happen. You know, that includes the Basically Beethoven Festival, our Hallam Family Concerts. We cannot happen without the support of the City of Dallas, Office of Arts and Culture, the Arts Community Alliance, TACA, Capital One, Moody Fund for the Arts, the Dallas Arts District Foundation, and the Texas Commission on the Arts. So we appreciate the support from those organizations. And of course, we appreciate the support from patrons like you. We appreciate your presence, and of course, we appreciate your dollars. Hey, you know, free is a free. Anyway, so we do have a little display out front that is manned by our new executive director, Morgan Vaughn. I hope you have a chance to meet with her. She has been with us a couple of months and is doing a fantastic job and is such a great steward of our resources, so I hope you get to know her. You can also make donations, of course, on our website, finearchchamberplayers.org, and we certainly appreciate all of your support and, you know, obviously your presence here today. A little bit of housekeeping, if you wouldn't mind taking a moment to make sure that all of your electronic devices are silent. We appreciate that, and our artists, of course, appreciate that. And I really hope you enjoy the show today. But wait, one more thing. I want to give a shout out. I've already mentioned our executive director, Morgan Vaughn, but I want to put out a special appreciation to Jeff Tallis. You've seen him wandering around backstage and on stage. You know, he is part of our staff, and he has been so amazing over these last few months, and he is very instrumental in making this Basically Beethoven Festival happen. So shout out to Jeff. Thank you, Jeff. He's busy getting everyone organized backstage. So right now, another person that I would like to appreciate and bring out here to speak with you a bit more is our artistic director of the Basically Beethoven Festival, Dr. Alex McDonald. So Alex would like to come and share with you a few things about our concert. So please welcome Alex McDonald.
Can everyone hear me all right? It is true that I have a doctorate, although when I got said doctorate, I looked at my dad and said, when you said you wanted a doctor in the family, you should have been more specific what kind. But at any rate, good afternoon. I am Alex McDonald, Festival Director for Basically Beethoven. I am delighted to see you all here. Fine Arts Chamber Players exists to enrich and enhance the quality of life for North Texas area residents, especially families and children, through free classical concerts and educational activities. We do this through the Hallam Family Concerts, which are held on Saturday afternoons throughout the school year, music residencies at the Dallas Public Schools, which provide individual and group lessons to students for free, they don't have to pay anything, and the Basically Beethoven Festival, where we are right now. So thank you very much for coming. That is, in a way, a form of support, because you are communicating to our sponsors that this is worth coming to, this is worth supporting. I also want to say a quick thank you to our volunteers. You may have seen some very friendly young folks. Rachel, Judy, Julia, Michelle, Melody, and Sean. And also Michelle for helping us with our raffle, so thank you. And I also want to thank all of you for being here. I see longtime concert attenders, as well as people here who are here for the first time. Thank you so much for coming. If you are here with a very little one, I want to first of all say thank you for bringing them. I'm so excited that young people can come and hear live music together. I think this is a sign that the arts are alive. I remember once hearing someone say that if you hear someone crying, well, certainly let's bring them to the lobby, but let's also be thankful that people are being exposed to the arts. Having said that, if it is at all possible, it's probably good to sit near an exit so that you can make a quick run to keep the hall relatively quiet for everyone else, as well as anyone who might be asleep. We want to protect that. And we will have the audio in the outside as well, so you can hear it out there. In fact, it's even better out there. We have a wrong note filter, sort of an auto-tune of sorts. So, let's see here. And it's already been said, but I'll say it again, if you wouldn't mind silencing your cell phones. It seems inevitable that one phone will go off somewhere, but if we can somehow silence them all, That would truly be something worth taking note of. Thank you so very much. Now, a huge part of keeping all of our concerts and all of our educational activities, yes, here it comes, how do we keep them free? Well, it's from support. And if any of you here are able to help us keep these programs free, we would be so thankful for your support. One of the ways you can do this is by getting to our raffle. You might win a gift card. I think we have a gift card to Apple. There's some money for the Cheesecake Factory. We also have a silent auction for two items. There's a music lessons, and this makes anybody think, you know, gee, I think I'd really like to take music lessons. Well, you can bid in a silent auction, and you can learn what it's like to be a frustrated musician, and in the process, support Fine Arts Chamber Players. And most excitedly, we have one of the beautiful paintings on your program by Joseph Kuipers, who is one of today's artists, playing cello for us. He has graciously donated a painting. And so we have a silent auction. All proceeds go to Fine Arts Chamber Players, and you can own a little piece of the series for that as well. Let's see here. We are alternating between concerts that are more war-themed and more peace-themed. This is one of the more peace-themed ones. Next week's concert features a very impactful and thought-provoking work, Messiaen's Quartet for the End of Time. Now, Messiaen, and you'll hear this if you listen to the WRR ads, the more serious ad will say some of this too, but here it is again. Mr. Messiaen was serving in the French Resistance during World War II. He was serving as an army nurse. He was captured by the Nazis and was placed in a Nazi war camp. It is in this harsh environment that Messiaen composed a quartet called Quartet for the End of Time. Messiaen was a devout Catholic, and in this work, Messiaen was inspired by the last book of the Bible, the Book of Revelation. This work focuses on themes of both divine judgment on evil, as well as meditations on God, as depicted in untouchable and transcendent beauty. The quartet was premiered for an audience of prisoners, as well as Nazi guards. It is one of the most impactful works of the 20th century. I'm excited that we are presenting it, and I hope to see you then. I'd also like to say a quick word about our rising stars. Both Ms. Kim and Mr. Neidegger are off to big things. Mr. Neidegger will study in Dresden, and Ms. Kim will go to the Curtis Institute. If you haven't heard of Curtis, that's because it is that selective. It's the same school that gave us Samuel Barber and Yu Zhou Wang. So all the best to both of them as they go on with their studies. I also would like to point out that the pieces in this rising star portion will be played in reverse order. First, we will have the Sonatine, and then we will end with the Jolivet. Thank you again so much for coming. I hope you enjoy the concert. Thank you. I'm just going to say the briefest word before we begin the program. Before we begin the Handel Halvorsen, Rachmaninoff, and Dvorak, I wanted to say just the briefest word about the vocalese, something that a friend had showed me that I thought was so interesting. Rachmaninoff, you may know, would frequently make use of a famous medieval melody called Dies Irae. Anyone familiar with Dies Irae already? This is amazing. What an educated crowd this is. When Dies Irae happens, you are ready. So, that was a joke, never mind. This melody dates back to the 13th century. It is titled The Day of Wrath, and it speaks of when the last trumpet summons souls before judgment. The final couplet of the poetry on which the chant is based is a Kyrie Jesu. Dear Lord Jesus, give them rest. Here is the Dies Irae melody. Now, Rachmaninoff quotes this melody in pieces like Rhapsody on a Theme of Paganini, in various places, but what's kind of cool about vocalese is, in a way, this melody is an artful re-expressing of that melody, vocalese being a song of mourning in this case. We chose this melody partly with reference to what's happening in Ukraine right now, so that was the reason for that particular bit of programming. I just wanted to make that oral connection with Dies Irae. That's all I have to say. Would you please join me in welcoming Jian Yun and Rachel McDonald?
I
Thank you.